Welcome to this step-by-step tutorial on configuring financials to bring in your own chart of accounts. Your chart of accounts serves as the foundation behind a precise financial plan and effective financial analysis. It should support your organization's accounting, information, and financial reporting requirements. A well-designed chart of accounts should contain consistent account names, elements, and attributes but offer flexibility for recording, reporting, and business growth. Let's say your company is in the process of implementing Enterprise Planning Cloud, which includes out-of-the-box business processes such as financials. You want to know how your existing chart of accounts fits in. While a complete chart of accounts is included to get you up and running quickly, financials also gives you the flexibility to use your own chart of accounts and still retain the benefits of the integrated financials framework. Plan using existing forms and dashboards. Review data on existing integrated financial statements. Perform calculations using existing rules. Integrate financials with other business processes. If you choose to create your own chart of accounts, you can enable base or parent features to create an account structure with key members for you to add your own chart of accounts. You can then input or import your own accounts for each enabled feature. If you initially create your own chart of accounts, you can incrementally enable the standard provided chart of accounts. In this tutorial, we'll go over how you can enable financials to bring in your own chart of accounts and leverage out-of-the-box features. Here's my application. I'll navigate to the configure page for financials and start enabling features. I'll select base features to create an account structure with key members. Next, I'll need custom dimensions. With flexible custom dimension usage, I can map or associate my custom dimensions to the appropriate base feature. Review your selections before running the enable process. Notice that I did not map products and services. I'll run the enable process. A system validation message is displayed because of the missing mapping. I'll fix the mappings for both dimensions. I'll run the enable process again. Enabling features takes a moment to complete. When finished, log off and back on to see your changes. Let's see what members were created in the account dimension. The financials cube contains the 81 members added during the enable process. Here are the parent key members and calculated KPIs required by financials. Here are the additional dimensions we mapped during the enable process. Before I can open dashboards and forms, I'll need to set values for the required user variables. Here's the financials card. I'll open the revenue dashboard. Some charts and dashboards use key members. After we load our own chart of accounts, updated and aggregated data will display here. On the second tab, driver and trend-based planning, notice that the horizontal tabs included only trend-based forms because we did not enable drivers. Let's take a quick look at the layout of one of the forms loaded during the enable process. The point of view includes user variable selections for version, currency, entity, and scenario. Custom dimensions plan element, product, services, and funding segment are also in this section. The page includes the year dimension and custom dimensions cost center and channel. Because we enabled cost center and channel only for some features such as expense, these dimensions are set in the page section by default. The row displays account members, while the column includes a conditional period dimension. Now, it's time to start bringing in our company's existing chart of accounts. You can either manually enter members or import them. We'll go over both methods, starting with manual entry. Here's a small section of our chart of accounts that we use to monitor profit and loss. To manually add my own chart of accounts, I'll use the Actions menu to add children and sibling accounts under the OFS Gross Profit key member. Here are my revenue accounts. Next, I'll add OFS Gross Profit and OFS Total Expenses as shared members under OFS Net Income. Some of the included charts and dashboards depict results from key members. Include accounts by adding them as shared members under the appropriate parent. The share can be at the level of detail required for your business. After you add accounts, refresh the database to apply your changes. Next, We'll import expense members for our chart of accounts. To start, we'll export a copy of our existing outline. This will serve as a template. On the Dimensions tab, click Export, then Create. I'll export my account dimension to a comma-delimited file so I can edit it in Excel. If you need to import members for other dimensions, you can select them as well. I'll save the exported zip file to a local folder, then open it. Here's my application's account structure. I can start adding our existing chart of accounts to this file so I can import it into my application. Our updated account structure includes a reporting structure for our income statement account. You can import dimension members on the Dimensions tab. I imported the rest of the chart of account members following the steps in the importing metadata video tutorial. For more information, visit the PBCS Cloud Help Center. Let's look at the imported members. Here are the expense accounts that we brought in. I can start planning or loading data. I can now plan expenses using my chart of accounts and out-of-the-box forms in Financials. For more information on loading data into Financials, please visit the PBCS Cloud Help Center and view the Loading Data in Oracle Enterprise Planning Cloud tutorial. Notice that Cost Center is not on this revenue form because we enable the custom dimension only for expense. Here's our Cost Center custom dimension. We can plan expenses using this dimension because it was associated with this feature during configuration. You can also incrementally add feature mappings for your enabled custom dimensions. Let's review. We configured Financials with key members and custom dimensions, entered account members from our chart of accounts manually, brought in our chart of accounts using the import functionality. While we brought in our chart of accounts, we are able to leverage out-of-the-box features from Financials, such as business rules, forms, and dashboards. In this tutorial, you learned how to bring in your own chart of accounts when you configure Financials. To learn more, visit cloud.oracle.com.